Hey, happy Tuesday, everybody. Mark again here, Weatherman Plus. I'm going to give you the latest update, not only what's going on with our severe weather for today and what could happen for tomorrow. Also, it has weakened down from what I can see. Also, what's going on in the tropics. Just like I've been telling y'all, we have something forming right in the very beginning of September, and anywhere from the 6th through the 10th, we have something really strong coming. Matter of fact, I'm starting to see in the ensembles that a major hurricane could be forming very soon. Now, where this goes, there's multiple directions. It could go out towards Bermuda again. A lot of them showing this could go towards the East Coast. Also seen a westward push and going into our Gulf for the last few runs, according to the Euro. So I'm going to show you all the latest information in this video. If you've never been here before, make sure you subscribe. I am all year along with my weather forecasting. Now, you can see right now, we're still getting a lot of rain. We're still getting a lot of strong wind reports coming through Minnesota. They lost good bit of power yesterday on those storms, and we do have them for today as well, and this is going to spread also for tomorrow going towards the northeast. Now, yesterday we did get a lot of rain reports, even some flood reports over in Massachusetts. We can also see that we also got the wind damage reports all the way from Minnesota, northern Wisconsin, into the UP of Michigan, showing right now you're over 150,000 homes without power in Minnesota, over 12,000 for Wisconsin. We'll refresh and see if it's gotten any better. It hasn't gotten any better. 154,000 for Minnesota and 14,000 for Wisconsin. This is going to move towards northern Michigan for today. Now, you can see we still have our convective outlook for today, but for tomorrow it is moving towards the northeast, and we get a little bit of that second storm that is going up on that higher ridge. There is a day three, but it is a marginal. It is for some weak storms pushing through, not showing a lot of strength of those at all. Now, for tomorrow, our chances for tornadoes is not going to be there. It's going to be for chances for wind and hail as this storm passes by the northeast, and I'm sure the hail is very minor. Matter of fact, when we look at Colorado State University for a chance for a tornado for today, they're not showing any in existence. But you can see as you go through the afternoon, these storms do start building up from northern Wisconsin, going towards the UP of Michigan. Not really strong for the UP, more like it's going to be stronger for the coast of Wisconsin right by the lake. Northern and southern starts popping up strong around 6 and 7 o'clock, goes across towards northern Michigan, and pushes over. And that's pretty much going to be it for today. Now, overnight, early morning hours, you got some more storms brewing up for Ohio going towards Pennsylvania. And not really much doing with those neither. But look early in the morning, you also have it moving through New England. Some storms pushing through, pretty weak system as it goes there. Gets a little bit more strength as it gets offshore. Now you see the storms moving across Indiana all the way towards northern Ohio for tomorrow afternoon. Then it builds up for southern Illinois. That does push across towards Pennsylvania as well as you go through the evening for Wednesday and overnight going into your Thursday. Now, the trend has been this starts weakening down as it goes closer towards the coast. And you can see the storms brewing up for Wednesday from that next storm system. So far, just showing North Dakota. It's been showing more and more of a northward pivot, so this would be less and less. Showing all the way until tomorrow morning, you could get some 50, maybe even pockets of 60 miles per hour wind gusts for northern and southern Wisconsin as those storms form up. Then from northern Michigan, going towards southeastern Michigan, towards northeastern Ohio. And you see the storms going by New England, barely have anything on them at all. While you get some winds pushing through Montana, Wyoming, some of Idaho from that next storm system. But then you have what comes through for tomorrow, all the way until Thursday morning, bringing another round of 50 and 60 miles per hour wind gusts coming with those storm cells as well. But you see how it starts weakening down as it goes across Pennsylvania. Latest tropical update has it for 20% for a chance for formation in the next 7 days. And I'm still showing this is going to be a major hurricane, whichever direction it goes, whether it goes far into the Atlantic, by the East Coast, or in the Gulf of Mexico. Some of these are showing all the way down to 920, 930 millibars. But still showing we have a chance to get some Gulf formation before that. Showing it will go in this direction and start going into that direction before we get this strong tropical wave pushing through. Chances for something to form up on the edge of the Gulf as that goes out. That is still a possibility. And then we get our next wave pushing through, and you see how it's moving more on that westward track, not that northward track going into the Atlantic. Now, as we start going 5 and 6 days, that's where it gets a chance for something to form up, maybe on the coast of the Gulf, maybe Louisiana, maybe Florida, maybe a little bit of Texas. It's been bouncing around a little bit, so we do need to watch for possible late formation. Then as we go literally 7 days away and beyond, there's our storm system starting to move to the west. But you see, as you go 9 days and 10 days, it becomes a deciding factor. Does it go this way? Does it go west? Or does it actually go further to the west? Because that's a new thing that's been popping in as we literally go 10 days. So it's still too far to know for sure, but you can see the different patterns that is in the potential chance for this storm to form. Showing in 5 days, something could form up in the Gulf of Mexico real quick and just form up to a strong tropical storm and come on landfall. Now, as we go past 6 and 7 days, here we are right at September 2nd, September 3rd, right when I was showing you last night in my last few updates, this is where a wave is going to potentially form. Now, if you watch the strength on this wave, now after this is where it starts getting closer and things start strengthening up. And you can see with the ensembles showing anywhere from a 928. Look at this. This is going all the way down to a 928 right here in the Florida panhandle. 950s, 940s. Look at the strength of these systems passing by. Showing 940s, 950s, a lot of 940s, a lot of 950s. And as you go further, look how much stronger they get. Showing it can stay on land as a strong hurricane. Be some 950s, 960s going towards the northeast. You see that? Multiple showing it could go right towards the northeast. Could be a fish storm as well, or maybe even affect Eastern Caribbean or the Bermuda. So we do need to watch out for that. But showing wherever it goes, whether it goes in the Atlantic, the East Coast, the Gulf of Mexico, or Western into the Gulf, showing potentially major hurricanes coming out of each one of these turns. And this is especially concerning. This right here is just looking like it's doing an Ian right there. Now, we'll keep you updated. It's just too far to know for sure which way this path is going to take just yet. I will start doing afternoon updates, and I will keep you informed. Latest run with the Ural takes it right into the Gulf. Takes it as a strong system going right into the Gulf. Now, the previous run took it a little bit further towards the east, so we are seeing a little bit more of that westward push. But you can see here from the ensembles that it's either going to go into the Atlantic, go along the east coast, or it's going to go into the Gulf, either Eastern Gulf or Western Gulf. So there's multiple locations that system can go. I will keep you updated. Plus, Global Tropics will do their update for today. I will post this on my community tab as soon as it comes out. And that has been your update, everybody. I just want to keep it quick and to the point of what's going on and the severe weather as well. The tropics, I don't want to take up too much of your time. I appreciate every single one of y'all. And afternoon updates will be starting soon. So make sure you click that bell and select all. Now, before you go today, Ecclesiastes 9, 7 through 9. Make sure no matter what's going on through life, God is in control. He's already won the fight. So enjoy your life. Matter of fact, Ecclesiastes 9, 7 through 10 instead of 7 through 9. Go thy way, eat thy bread with joy, and drink thy wine with a merry heart. For God now accepteth thy works. Let thy garments be always white, and let thy head lack no ointment. Live joyfully with the wife whom thou lovest all the days of the life of thy vanity, which he hath given thee under the sun. All the days of thy vanity, for that is the portion in this life, and in thy labor which thou takest under the sun. Whatsoever thy hand findeth to do, do with thy might, for there is no work, nor device, nor knowledge, nor wisdom in the grave whither thou goest. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I wish the best for every single one of y'all. Remember, do not push off for tomorrow what you can do for today. Live for today. Do not live for tomorrow. We don't know what tomorrow may bring. Only God knows that. Remember, all glory does go to God. our Father in heaven, Yahweh. And I always hope he keeps you safe every single day of your life and everyone around you and forever. Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Have a great day, everybody. I'll see you tomorrow. Possibly even updates starting that quick.